his mountain. Looked all around, couldn't find nobody. Went down into the deepest valley. Looked all around down there, couldn't find nobody. I went across the deep blue sea, couldn't find one to compare to your grace, your love, your mercy. Nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater, no. Nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater. Nobody greater than you. Nobody can heal like you can. Oh, most holy one, you are the great I am. Awesome in all your ways, and mighty is your hand. You are he who carried out redemption's plan. You are he who carried out redemption's plan.
Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody.
Nobody great. Nobody greater, Jesus.
Nobody greater than you.
Searched all over.
Searched all over.
Couldn't find no.
Couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low. Still couldn't find nobody.
Nobody great. Nobody great.
Nobody greater than you.
Come on, lift those hands for real in here. Come on. Nobody greater. Nobody greater, Jesus.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody greater. Nobody greater. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Now lift those hands, singers, and let's just give them the glory. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Couldn't find nobody.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody greater than you.
I dare you lift your hands and say that with us tonight. Come on. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Body greater.
Nobody greater.
Body greater than you.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody like you, Jesus. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
No matter where you look or where you
nobody
go.
Nobody greater.
Mercy,
oh, grace.
Today's a new day, but where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's all right.
I'll be honest with you.
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower.
When I think how much better I'm gonna be when this is over. You do.
I smile.
Come on and
smile. It's so hard to look up when you've been down. Sure would hate to see you give up now.
God's people.
You look so much better when you smile. So smile.
Now every day ain't gonna be perfect, but it still don't mean today don't have purpose. Come on.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds and it's dark in my heart and it feels like a cold night.
It ain't easy, but
today's a new day. But tell me, where are my blue skies?
Where is that love, y'all?
Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
The truth is,
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain.
That Holy Ghost power, y'all.
Fell from heaven. The shower down.
Now I know we've been hurt, y'all, but still
I smile.
Come on.
Even though I hurt, see, I smile.
Y'all feel that?
I know God is working, so I smile. Even though I've been here for a while,
still
I smile.
Hallelujah.
I smile. It's so hard to look up when you've been down. Sure would hate to see you give up now.
God's people.
You look so much better when you smile.
Whatever you're in right now,
smile, smile for me.
Smile.
Can you just smile for me?
And my people say,
oh, 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 you look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh. You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh. You look so much better when you're, oh,
I say,
oh, oh. You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
And while you're waiting,
you look so much.
Yeah, and while you're praying,
you look so much better when you're,
look in the mirror,
you look so much better when you're,
always remember,
you look so much better when you smile.
Come on.
I almost gave up,
I almost gave up,
that I can't explain,
but the Holy Ghost power, y'all,
fell from heaven,
came
like
down from heaven,
down.
Hardships, difficulties,
right now,
tears, storms, this is what I do. Oh, that feels good.
I know God is working, so I smile.
All things are working.
Even though I've been here for a while,
still
I smile. Smile.
Hallelujah.
It's so hard to look up when you've been down.
I know it's hard right now.
Sure would hate to see you give up now.
Because you're a winner.
You look so much better when you smile.
You look better.
So smile. Oh, oh, oh.
Dallas.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
New Orleans.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
Come on. Cleveland.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh.
Detroit.
You look so much better when,
yeah,
you're, oh, oh, oh.
Philly.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
Jersey.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
LA.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
All my people say,
you look so much better when you smile.
See, I just don't want you to be happy, cause then you gotta have something happening. I want you to have joy, cause can't nobody take that from you. I see you smiling.
Yeah. trouble. Found him to be a friend of mine. In time, storm my mind. He'll be there. All your burdens, I know the law. Help you to bear.
This morning, amen. 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 I'm gonna need your help this morning for the past couple of weeks. I've been faking it and making it with the voice. I need your voice today, amen. Even if you got on fancy shades today, I need your voice today, amen. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm glad to see you on this morning. Tell somebody else, neighbor, we made the wake up list this morning. Aren't you glad you made the wake-up list this morning? Hallelujah. If it had not been for the Lord on our side, where would we be on this morning? Somebody tell your neighbor, I'm grateful. I don't hear you. I'm grateful. I'm grateful. Come on. I'm grateful. Are you grateful? Are you glad to be alive? Are you grateful to be alive this morning? Come on, let's give God praise. The song says, with my hands lifted up and my mouth filled with praise, I need you to stand and help me. Amen. Amen. And if you can't stand, I need you to sing. Amen. In my choir rehearsals, I tell them to sit up so you can get it out. Amen. With my hands lifted up and my mouth filled with praise. Come on, I don't hear you. God of thanks, I will bless thee. With my hands lifted up and my mouth with a heart, come on. Come on, use your street voice. I will bless thee. Oh, with my hands lifted up. And with a heart, I will bless thee. One more time, lift your hands and voice and say, with my hands, good morning. With praise, come on, with the thanks, with the heart of thanksgiving, I will bless thee. Come on, let's ring it out. I will bless thee, O Lord. With the heart, with the heart of thanksgiving, with the heart, come on, with the heart of thanksgiving, with the heart, come on, push, with the heart of thanksgiving. With a heart of thanksgiving, I will bless thee. Come on, one more time. I will bless thee, O Lord. Come on. Come on, I will bless thee. He's been too good to us. He woke us up this morning, closing our right mind. Anybody glad you got your right mind this morning? I will bless thee, O Lord. With a heart. With a heart of thanksgiving. Come on. My heart says yes. With a heart of thanksgiving. Oh, thank you, thank you. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, with a heart. Come on. With a heart of thanksgiving. Come on, with a heart. With a heart of thanksgiving. Woo, hey. With a heart of thanksgiving. My heart says thank you. With a heart of thanksgiving. With a heart of thanksgiving. Come on, help me sing. With a heart of thanksgiving. With a heart of thanksgiving. My hands go up. My mouth gets filled with praise. Oh, I thank you, Lord. Oh, I thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. 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 Come on. Clap your hand and say, thank you, Lord. Don't stop saying it. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. You've been so good to me, Lord. I gotta thank you, Lord. I don't deserve your grace nor your mercy. You woke me up in my right mind with a few aches and pains, but I still say thank you, Lord. Come on, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on. Oh, thank you, Lord. Come on. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Come on, tell him thank you. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Can I get somebody to walk around and say thank you? Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on, tell him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hey, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for my healing. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you, Lord. You ought to thank him for your family members. Somebody ought to thank him for your mother. Thank him for your father. Thank him, Lord. Thank you, Lord. They might be sick, but you ought to tell them, thank you, Lord. They're still here. You might be sick in your body, but you're still here. You ought to tell them, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Take your time. But tell him thank you. Thank you, Lord. Lord, you've been good to us. We thank you, Lord. We're thanking you in advance. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Take your time. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. My heart says, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. If you ain't got nothing to thank him, thank him for life, health, and strength. You made it here today. You made it all week long. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Come on, thank him. Come on, thank him. He healed your body. He delivered you. When the doctors gave up, God was right there. Can I get a witness? Tell your neighbor, I gotta thank him. I gotta thank him. I gotta thank him. I gotta thank him. You brought me out of danger scene and scene. You kept me when I wanted to give up. Thank you, Lord. You might have to cry, but I'm going to tell them thank you, Lord. 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 Tell your neighbor, excuse me if I get a little ugly, but tell him when I think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he done for me. Tell him my makeup might go to running and my curls may fall out, but that's all right. That's all right. You don't know what the Lord has done for me. You don't know what he done for me. Tell him you don't know what he done for me. That's the why I praise him the way I do. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Somebody need to tell him thank you. You ain't told him thank you all week long, but thank you for another week. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for healing. Thank you for being my Savior. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you. I just want to thank you. I just want to thank you. I just want to thank you, Lord. Come on, tell them thank you. Come on, open up your mouth and tell them thank you. Clap your hand and tell them thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for healing. Thank you for deliverance. We need you to go all the way down south and touch those who are sick, Lord. Make your way on up Midway. Touch those who are sick, Lord. Make your way all the way to New York and touch right now. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. Right now, Jesus. Right now, Lord. We gotta have you, Lord. We need you to go in the White House, woo, and turn things around. Stop the enemy right now, in the name of Jesus. Jesus! Come on, lift your voice. Get your hands up. Woo, hey. Hold your head back and say, Lord, do it for me. Lord, do it for me right now. Come on, come on. Even if you're sitting down, it's all right. But lift your head down and shout, Lord, do it for me. Lord, do it for me right now. Somebody say, I need you to do it right now. Anybody needing to do it right now? Shout out, Lord, do it right now. If you don't do it, it just won't get done. Lord, do it right now. Lord, do it right now. If you're sick, lay your hands on your body. Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask you to heal, deliver right now. Try it up. Turn the doctor's report around. In the name of Jesus, he said one thing, but we know you as a healer. Somebody say, do it, Lord. Y'all know where we going, right? Y'all know where we going, right? I put my trust in. Y'all gonna help me out? Forget about yourself. Forget about those who's around you. Close your eyes and open up your mouth and say, I put my trust in. Now, if you're not a believer, don't open your mouth and say it. But if you will believe and know that God can do it and he's done it for you before, come on. Go to somebody. I know you're sick of me, but it's all right. Go from one side to the other side. That means both sides move. Go to somebody and tell them, neighbor. Tell them, say, neighbor. I just stopped by this morning to tell you it's getting ready to happen. Tell them, it's getting ready to happen. Tell them, keep on believing. Keep on trusting. It's getting ready to happen. Tell them the doctor said one thing, but when they go back, they won't find what they said. Shout and tell them it's getting ready to happen. You ain't got to have a whole conversation. Just tell them that. Shout, it's getting ready to happen. Tell them, put my trust in God. Anybody put your trust in God? Man, a failure. Your boo, your side piece, your spouse, they'll fail you. But tell your neighbor, I put my trust in God. I gotta go. I got 1 minute. But can we give them 30 seconds? Can we give them 30 seconds? If you put your trust in them, you don't need nobody to shout with you. Clap your hands and open your mouth. Come on, let's go. Come on. After you put your request in, you gotta praise them. Everybody jump. The way in the sound room. Come on. Come on. And if you're sitting down, just bounce. Excuse me, but I gotta get it out. Come on, everybody. I got to praise. Come on. I got to praise. I got to go, but I just heard the Spirit of the Lord say, if you praise me, I'll take the sting out of defeat. One, two, three, come on. Come on, come on, praise me. He said, if you praise me, I'll take the sting out of defeat. Come on. Don't just clap your hands. Open your mouth and tell them thank you. Let your feet testify. Come on, let them testify. You don't got to worry about your dance, but everybody move your feet. You ain't moving them. If you're sitting down, pat them. We got about 10 more seconds. I feel it. Come on. Tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor, will you help me praise him? One, two, one, two. Everybody jump. Your neighbor, I just had a flashback how good God has been to me. Tell him he brought me out when I couldn't bring myself out. Lord, do it for me. Oh Lord, do it for me. Lord, do it for me. Oh Lord, do it for me. Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't be done. Oh Lord, do it for me. Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't be done. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. You got to call him. Come on, open your mouth and say, oh, Lord. Hey, Kopa, oh Lord, open up your mouth and call him, shout, oh Lord. Lord, you are Lord, Lord of everything. You better come on. What you need
It's in the praise. Come on, we're right there. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, the tears you see, they're not tears of sorrow, but they're tears of joy, because I found out weeping may endure for a night. But tell somebody, my morning is here. I wish I could get somebody to jump up and shout, my morning is here. Well, since my morning is here, I'm just gonna tell him, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Clap your hands. Open up your mouth and tell them thank you. Keep on praising them. You don't need no music. One day it ain't gonna be no music.
Yes,
one day we ain't gonna be able to get to church.
Yes,
but while
Lord.
I'm here, I'm gonna praise him in advance. Come on, open your mouth all over this place and get your hands up and open your mouth.
Hallelujah.
And give God praise.
Yes, Lord.
You ain't got no issues, praise him for somebody else.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody's sick in your family, pray for them.
Praise him anyhow. Yes, Lord. Say, I don't know what you come to
open
do.
Open up your mouth. Stop playing. Open up your mouth and tell God thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
I got to go, but come on, let's tell him thank you on the way out. Open up your mouth and tell him thank you on the way out.
Thank you.
Say, God, I'm thanking you.
Thank you,
come
Jesus.
Come on, thank him.
Thank you, Lord.
Open up your mouth and tell him thank you.
Thank you.
Come, don't look at me. Tell him thank you.
Thank you.
Open up your mouth and tell him thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I gotta go, but I tell you, I feel the power of God.
Yes, Lord.
Come on, tell the Lord thank you.
Woo.
Thank you, Jesus.
Put your hands
thank
together.
You, God, we
put
thank
your hands
you.
Together. Yes,
come
Lord.
Come on, open your mouth and tell him thank you. Oh, thank God, you. We thank you this morning.
We thank
God,
you.
God, we want you to heal the people everywhere.
Yes,
in
Lord.
In the name of Jesus, in God, you're Jesus. Able to do it right now.
Yes,
right
Lord.
Right now, Lord. Right now, God. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Heal, Lord. In
yes,
the name
Lord.
Of Jesus.
In the name
heal,
of Jesus.
Lord.
Yep.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name
heal,
of Jesus.
Heal, Lord.
Yes,
in
Lord.
In the name of Jesus. Heal, Lord.
Heal, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Heal, Lord.
Heal, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name
heal,
of Jesus.
Lord. Heal, Lord.
Heal, Lord. Yes, Lord. Say, I don't know what you come to do, but we come to praise God this morning. Yes. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Give thanks. Give thanks. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for waking me up this morning. Thank you for life today. Thank you for the joy that I have. Yes, Lord. Woo! We got so many things. Oh, Heavenly Father. Yes, Lord. Thank you for your son, Jesus, dying to save us from the sins that we commit. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give God the highest praise you can give him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Have your way, Lord Jesus. Be with us on this day. Yes, Lord. Praise his holy name. Praise his holy name. Praise his name. Hallelujah. That's right. Give God the praise. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Show your presence, O Heavenly Father. Show your presence. Give thanks. Just praise him anyhow. Praise him. Give God the praise. Give God the praise. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you.
Have your way, have your way. Have your way, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Have your way. Have your way, God. Have your way. Show yourself strong. Show yourself strong.
Thank you for your mighty presence, O Heavenly Father. Thank you. Yes, Lord, we just want to give thanks to God Almighty just for having us to be able to come here today. We thank God for Pastor Moore to bring us the song and the praise. We thank you for your presence today, O Heavenly Father. We thank you for your presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. You may be seated. You may be seated. Thank you. Be seated if you could be seated. If not, continue to praise him.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Yes, God.
Call his name. Call his name. Right where you're sitting at. Just give him the praise. You know what you need to thank God for today. Thank him. Yes, Lord. We thank you, God, for Macedonia Baptist Church. Yes, Lord. We thank you for our leader. Yes, Lord. We thank you for our leader, our shepherd, Pastor Evan D. Gray. Thank you for sending him our way. We thank you. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, God. Praise him. Praise him. Yes, God. Praise him.
Hallelujah. Yes, the highest praise you could give him, yes, is that hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give him, give hallelujah. Him his praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, God. Woo.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, God. Yes, God. Even now. Yes, God.
Yes. Continue to praise him. Continue to praise him.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We thank you. We thank you. Can't stop thanking you. Thank you for life itself. Thank you for your presence.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
We thank you for the presence of the Holy Spirit,
yes,
O Heavenly
God.
Father.
Yes, God. Thank you.
Let it rain down upon us.
Hallelujah.
Your will, your grace.
Yes, God.
We ask these things. Yes, Lord.
Yes. Have your way, God.
Thank you, God.
Jesus.
So our pastor is not here today,
Jesus.
But we thank God for him anyway. We ask God to be with him in the presence where he's at today.
Thank you, Lord.
We're going to receive a message today.
Hallelujah.
From our very own.
Thank you, Jesus.
Errol Hylton, Senior.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank
God always has a way of bringing his message to you. So we're asking God to use him. Use his lips to deliver his message to us today, O Heavenly Father. Please use him. Continue to use him. And we ask that you continue to be amongst us today as we receive your word, O Heavenly Father. We ask that you open our hearts, our minds, our spirit to be able to receive your word, to hear your word, to understand your word, O Heavenly Father. We ask just you to be with us. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
So if you would receive
Thank you, Jesus.
Our messenger today.
Thank you, Lord.
Reverend Hylton.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 We bless your name, God. We lift you up, God. We give you reverence, God. Because you alone are worthy. Only you alone are worthy. You are worthy for all honor. You are worthy for all glory. You are worthy for all praise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I feel something happening. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
The Spirit of God is moving in this place.
Yes, he is.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your present.
Thank you.
Thank you for your glory.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for your Shekinah glory, God. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for your present, God.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You have been so good to us.
Yes, you have.
We just say thank you.
Thank you.
God, we not asking you for nothing, oh God.
Yes, Lord.
We just come to express our thanks to you this morning.
Yes, Lord.
We just want to let you know how much we adore you, how much we appreciate you. Because you have been so good to us.
Yes.
That's why we come to say thank you.
Thank you.
We say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
We say thank you.
Thank you.
We thank you, oh God.
Thank you.
We thank you for your loving kindness.
Thank you.
We thank you for your many tender mercy.
Thank you.
We just thank you, God.
Thank you.
We magnify you. We lift you up. We lift you up, oh God. Because you alone are worthy. You alone are worthy, God. You worthy for all honor. You are worthy for all praise. That's why we lift the name of Jesus. Because you said every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Shabonka Shadinga, Jesus Shabota, is Lord. In the name of Jesus, Shanda Naboshita, you are God. You are God. And beside I, there is not another. That's why we call upon that name. There is no name under the sun that man can save other than the name above every name. The name of Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, the bread when I'm hungry, Jesus, the water when I'm thirsty, Jesus, my rock in a weary land, Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus, 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 we're calling on that name, have mercy, have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. You are a merciful God. Have mercy.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. There is no name.
Yes, Lord.
His name is above every name.
Yes,
there is no name.
Yes.
I can't call upon no other name. No name can save me.
Yes.
No name can help me other than the name of Jesus. There is something about that name. When I call on that name, demon tremble at the name of Jesus. When I call on that name, I have joy, unspeakable joy. when I call on that name, I have love. I call on that name, I have peace. At the name of Jesus, Jesus, Jesus will allow my enemy to become a footstool. Jesus, only Jesus, only Jesus. At the name of Jesus, at the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Jesus, cry out from the pit of your belly and call his name. There is something about when you call his name, and he said, when you call, I will hear you and I will answer you. Call. Call his name. Call his name. Call his name. Something happened when I call the name of Jesus. Hey, call his name. Call his name. I don't want to go above. I don't want to go ahead. But I'm telling you, I feel something. Because the Bible teaches us that when the Spirit of God came in, even the Spirit, the priest, could not even stand to minister. And that's how I feel this morning. I feel like I cannot even minister because there's a burden on me that I'm feeling in this place. And I just want to call on the name that above every name, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Call on him. 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 Jesus. 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 You are not going through nothing. You are not going through nothing. So if you're not going through something, you can't call on him. You got to go through something to know who he is. Amen, somebody. If you've been through something and the Lord have brought you through, you should have a praise to let him know, I'm going to call on him. I'm going to call on him. I'm going to call on him. My brother and my sister, there is something about when the present of the Spirit is harboring in our circumference. Don't take it lightly, because things in your home began to change. Come on, somebody. Family member began to turn around. Things began to happen that is unusual. When the power of praise is in his house, the word teaches us we must enter into his house with thanksgiving, into his court with praise. But the key thing, in spite of how you feel and in spite of what you're going through, the word teaches us, be thankful and bless his name, because the Lord is good. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Be thankful and bless his name, because the Lord is good. Not that he's only good, but his mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God, I got to get some pastoral emphasis out the way. But I'm telling you, my brother and my sister, there is something stirring up inside of me. Yes, Lord. I'm telling you, my brother and my sister. Yes. But I got to have some pulpit etiquette. I want to get something out the way. Yes. I just want you to help me worship him. Can you do that for me? Yes. I just want to worship him. I don't know where you want to worship him for, but whatever your heart desire, Just put it in front of you.
Yes, Lord.
And whatever is your heart desire, my sister.
Yes.
I'm telling you, you're touching yourself. Mm-hmm. And you're believing. But I come to give you a word this morning. Whatever your heart desire,
yes.
You're leaving church this morning.
Yes.
And you're going to receive your desire.
Yes, Lord.
Amen, somebody.
Amen,
amen, somebody.
Amen.
I'm speaking this morning prophetically. It's a prophetic announcement.
Yes,
I'm speaking this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Prophetic,
yes.
Announcement. That whatever you ask,
yes.
God for,
yes.
He said, if you believe,
yes.
You shall.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey, God.
Praise.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, God.
Let me get this pastoral emphasis out the way. Because I feel something going to happen in this house. This morning, because many of us is going through, and you don't know what a person is going through. You can see the smile, but you can't see the tears. Amen, somebody. But I come to teach you something this morning. My God said he will wipe away all tears from your eyes. Come on, somebody. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Let me get this pastoral emphasis out the way.
Yes.
Let me say happy birthday to you, Sister Martha Cutley.
Yes.
Happy birthday, and may God continue to bless and keep you.
Hallelujah.
To you, my brother and my sister, who is watching us virtually or who is in the sanctuary, our church anniversary is quickly approaching.
Yes.
Our 92nd anniversary. Our 92nd anniversary,
yes.
Is quickly approaching. And I'm hearing somebody said, how can I be a part of it? Listen to my foolish advice. Because everybody can do like what you do. But I want to give you a foolish advice. If you want to be a part of it, starting today, start talk $3 away. You might can't come up with $92 at once. Talk from today, start talk. $3 in a little envelope,
yeah.
And say, you know what, this is going to mount up to my $92 when the anniversary come. Amen.
Amen.
And I guarantee you, if you do that in 30 days, your anniversary money will be there.
Yeah.
No stress. Turn to somebody and say, no stress.
No stress.
It's all $3 a day.
$3.
Come on, somebody.
$3.
Come on, somebody. Sometimes you got to do what you can do to make it easy just for you.
Yes.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
You can't back out the $92, but I'm going to talk $3 a day.
Yes.
Every day I'm going to put my $3 down because I want to be a part of this 92 church anniversary to see the church go forth. Amen, somebody. And we're going to continue to keep our pastor in prayer.
Yes.
Our sister, Sister Black, she are the one who have all the t-shirts for the church anniversary.
Yes.
You can place your order to her while you're leaving the sanctuary today. The t-shirt is only $20. Why it is so expensive? We have to buy the t-shirt. And we have to put the labels on the t-shirt. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So we just working your $20 just for you.
Yes.
Amen, somebody.
Yes.
To make you be unified with us. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So that's what we need to do. Put your $3 away. I start put my $3 away already. Because I can't afford to just buy $92. I like to do it little by little. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Because we learn one cocoa, full basket. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So learn to tuck it away.
Yes.
And it's going to mount up. Amen.
Amen.
We bless the name of Jesus. Amen. Let me do this. To the deacons. To the deaconesses.
to the ushers, to the missionaries, and to all you, my brother and sister in Christ, I greet you with the joy of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
One thing with me, I go by the Spirit. I don't care if my pastor wanna be here, he know me. I respect him. But when the Spirit move me, I don't move by people. I don't move by voices. You are not my strong advocate. You are not my cheerleader. God is my cheerleader. God is my advocate. So when he tell me to work, I'm going to work while it is day. Come on, somebody. Yeah. Now I'm getting everything out the way. Give me 5 minutes. And I'm going to get out of your way also. Let me go to this great book, the book of the Torah, the book of the Pentateuch, the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter number 12. Genesis chapter number 12. And I'm going to read a couple of verses from verse 1. Now the Lord had said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show thee, and I will make thee a great nation, and I will bless thee and make thee great, and thou shalt be a blessing, and I will bless them that bless thee, and I will curse him that curseth thee, and in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. I want you to look at what I'm telling you this morning. And all I'm going to say to you quickly and get out of your way, the promises is mine. I don't know about you. I say the promises is mine. So if you say to yourself that the promises is yours, whatever your promise that God have for you, you will already accept it. The promises is mine. May the word of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord God. You are my strength and you are my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. My brother and my sister, the promise is mine. Sometimes in life, we oftentimes tell ourselves, it don't seem possible after waiting for so many years. We wait for that promise. Somebody promised us something, and it seems like it will never come true. But my God, when he promised you, to let you know that if he said it, we got to believe it. Yeah. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
When God said, I will never leave you, that simply means when time me and myself and I alone is by myself.
Yes.
I know that I'm not by myself because he said he will never leave me. So if God said he will never leave me, why must I worry? Come on, my brother and my sister. Because, not because I'm isolated by myself, laying on my back in the bed of affliction, that means my promise will not come to fruition. Amen, somebody. You have to understand in life, you must go through something. David said, even though I go through something, I will fear what? No evil. Amen, somebody.
Yes.
If you don't go through something, you do not know the God whom you serve. Every now and then, when you go through something, that's the time you draw somebody closer to Him. Amen, somebody. But you must go through something. Let me pause here quickly before I get in trouble. Thank God to bring back our sister. Amen. She went to Barbados and she returned back to us safely in spite of Hurricane Beryl. Come on, somebody. Sister Simon, we thank God for her. Thank God that Sister Tracy also in the house. Amen, somebody. So we thank God. Let me get back to my text now. My brother and my sister, so when you look at life, life full a lot of peaks and valley. Life full a lot of ups and down. So when you look at the writer as he wrote this morning and he began to explain to you and I, Abraham was a young boy. Abraham, A-B-R-A-M. That means before God can change you, He got to take you out of some things. Yes, come on, somebody. Amen, amen, somebody. Amen. What God does, God allow him to see what was transpiring around him. Mm-hmm. I am coming to church, and if I'm seeing you worship, and I'm sitting down like a log, that means I got what I want. But if I fall into worship, amen, somebody, and make a joyful noise unto the Lord, then I can see the works of God. Amen, somebody. Because the word teaches us that it's good that we assemble amongst the saints. That means when we come to church, we come to church to give God praise. Amen, somebody. We don't come to church to look over here or look over there. Here we find the writer Abraham, as he wrote, the Bible teaches us, he said, go. It simply means you got to forget about everything. Don't worry about your comfort zone. Don't worry about your community. Don't worry about nothing. Because what is transpiring around you is not good for you. That's why you got to be careful of those who taking up their phone and calling you about somebody. Let them know, hold a minute, let me get the three-way line and all three of us reason this out together. Yes. Amen, somebody. Amen. Because if you are my brother keeper, you got to uphold me. You can't pull me down. Amen, somebody. God speak to Abraham. Abraham, he said, Abraham, listen to me. I know some things is going on around you that's not looking appropriate. But one thing I want you to do for me, I just want you to wait. Yes. Amen, somebody. Amen. Because in order for you to receive the promise of God, you got to wait. Amen, somebody. Amen. That means you got to go through a process. Yes. Amen, somebody. Because when you go through your process, then you will see the power and the position that God have in store for you. Yes. Amen. Amen. He said, leave thy mother and thy father. Go. The Bible said Abraham counted as righteousness. Why? Because he hear the voice of God. When God speak to you, don't ignore it. So as Abraham get prepared to go, when Abraham get ready to go, you know how old Abraham were? Do you know how old he were? Do you know how old he were? I want, so anybody tell me that, come on class. He was 75 years old, read the Bible. It is right there in the text. He was 75 years old. But when he was a boy, he see the culture. The culture is they wasn't representing
the true and living God. They was representing idol. That's why we can't come to church and worry about idol worshiper. Amen, somebody. Because when you come to church, you got to worry about worship him, because him alone is worldly. Amen, somebody. Abraham's father was an idol worshiper. So God got to move him before he could give him the promise. And we see what the promise is all about. God said, I will make a great nation. I will make your seed be blessed. Everywhere you go, you shall be blessed. You shall be blessed going. You shall be blessed coming. You shall be blessed in the city. And you shall be blessed in the field. So what are you saying to me, brother? I'm making you know that no weapon formed against you shall prosper, because I got the promise. Come on, somebody. Amen, somebody. And when you have the promise, the devil in hell can't do nothing about it. Why? Because the Lord is covering me. Amen, somebody. God said to Abraham, no, go. As Abraham was on his way doing what he needed to do and do what God's commandment for his life were, immediately strife and destruction come his way. His own uncle, who said, you know what, I'm not going to stay behind. You know, lad, I'm going with you, Abraham, because I know that there's something about you. Lot went with him, but immediately Lot want what Abraham has. Amen, somebody. Amen. You don't know how early in the morning I got to get up and pray while you sleeping in your bed. So when you see me get blessed, amen, somebody, you don't know my sacrifice. Amen, somebody, because you're not sacrificing yourself. So don't get upset with me, because the same God that I pray to, you can pray also to him. And if he do it for you, he will do it also for me. Amen, somebody. One thing with a promise, and when God promised us, he promised us through his word. That's why he always teaches us through his word. He said we must lean not to our own understanding. Yes. Our own understanding is telling us that it is impossible. I can't walk through those doors. I can't walk upon those shores. That's our own understanding. Mm-hmm. Yes. I'm not capable enough. Come on, somebody. But there is no secret that God can't do. God can put you anywhere, at any time, and whenever he wants to do. Amen, somebody. All we got to do is keep our eyes on his promise. Because the promise belongs to me. When Abraham see what was transpiring around him, Abraham said, I got to leave this place, because in those days in Mesopotamia, which is in of Ur of the Chaldees, in those days they were great master builder. They were carver. Amen, somebody. Yes. But Abraham was a farmer. Amen, somebody. Yes. What they was doing, they was carving gods out of stone. Yes, they were. Amen, somebody. Amen. And while they was carving gods out of stone, that's the God they present to the people. Yes. So now the people gravitate to what they are seeing. But I'm not seeing my God, but I can feel my God. Yes. Come on, somebody. Amen, somebody. Amen. Abraham, he declared first thing, he said, listen, I can't serve that God. I got to serve the one who is the rock. And the rock is Jesus Christ. Come on, somebody. You got to know who is your rock. I'm not talking about the rock that they carve out a God in. I'm talking about the rock in the weary land. Come on, somebody. Amen. I'm talking about the rock of Gibraltar. I'm talking about the rock that Peter said upon this church. God said upon this church, upon this rock, I will build my church. And the gate of hell shall not prevail against it. That rock is Jesus. So I'm not worshiping no other God. And I'm not worshiping no one. And I'm not bowing down to no one. Because my Bible teach me that when I bow down, he will lift me up. Come on, somebody. So no matter what it seems and looking like, God is still in control. Come on, somebody. God is still in control. Come on, somebody. But my brother, you don't understand. Right now, I got somebody in the hospital. I got somebody not doing good. Again, I'm going to go back. Lean not to your own understanding. Because your understanding can make you see but so far. Amen, somebody. But we got to remember, with God, all things. My brother and my sister, when we look and see the life of Abraham, we see when God said, I will bring a great nation out of you. Look at what transpired in Abraham's life. He get the promise. It did not seem in his own eyes that it was going to come to fulfillment. Because Abraham, when he was going through, and when he was entering through Egypt, the first thing he said to his wife, he said, Sarah, you are a beautiful woman. But listen, I know that their eyes is on you. Yes. They are going to kill me. Yes. But they're going to save you. But Abraham do not know that the God that he serve will confuse the mind of the enemy. Come on, somebody. Amen. I said the God that you serve will confuse the mind of the enemy. Yes, Lord. So when Pharaoh do accept Sarah, who is his wife, God turn around and allow that situation to become his success. Immediately, Pharaoh looked at Abraham and said, my God, what have you done telling me that she is your sister? Yes. Come on, my brother. But, nevertheless, I'm not going to prolong this conversation with you. Take your wife. Yes. Take this. Yeah. Take that. Take whatever it is. And go. And just leave my place. Amen, somebody. Yes. That's the God we serve. God will save something up for you what not belongs to you. Yes. Yes, Lord. That's the God we serve. When it seems like there is no hope, hope is on the other side. Come on, somebody.
Yes, Lord.
When you look at how God operates, God said, Abraham, all I need you to do is just stay humble. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
You're going to go through some difficult moment. You're going to have some dark days. You're going to have some stormy days. You're going to have some rainy days. But just stay calm. Don't give up on faith. Amen, somebody. I know what the diagnosis is, but please don't give up on faith.
Because if you believe that there is a God, and he is the one who wake you up this morning, give you another opportunity. Not that he only give you an opportunity, but he clothed us in our right mind. Who wanna serve a God like this? Come on, somebody. Who wanna serve a God like this? I know him. That the promise that he gave Abraham, it not only belongs to him, but it belongs to every one of us who is in this sanctuary. Because him said, the earth shall be blessed by what you have done. I command you, you did not resist. You go and you do the command. What I ask you to do. My brother and my sister, when God tell you to do something, don't make nobody question it. Right. Amen, somebody. I know that your credit is not looking good. Yeah. But if God said go into that dealer, because that car is yours, your name is already written on it. If he said go for that closing, that means the key is already waiting for you. Amen. All you got to do is just go and possess what God has for you. Amen, somebody. Amen. And when I look at the life of Abraham, and I see all the accomplishment that God have let him accomplish by obedient, I'm telling you, my brother and my sister, just as I tell you earlier, if you took $3 away, that's obedient. You can be a part of the church anniversary. Not that only be a part of the church anniversary, but when the church anniversary finish, you can still put that $3 away. And you're going to see how that $3 mount up to great emergency one day for you. Come on, somebody, if you believe, clap. Come on. I'm telling you, all you got to do is just be obedient. Because the word teaches us that obedient is better than sacrifice. And my brother and my sister, why you know that the promise is yours? I'm going to leave you now because I hold it too long. Why you know the promise is yours? Because he allowed me to wake this morning. Amen, somebody. And while he wake me up this morning, he give me a purpose. I don't know about you, my brother, and I don't know about you, my sister. But when I stretch my hand this morning to him, and when he look on me, he said unto him, who is able to keep me from falling and present me faultless before his throne, the only wise God. I don't know about you this morning, but I come to encourage you, my brother and my sister, that if you hold on a little while longer, God will see you through. I know you've been going through your sickness for a mighty long time, but I've come to tell you this morning, those that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They will mount up with wings like eagle. All you got to do is just learn to wait. And I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait until my change come. Because I know my change is coming. Because I've been down too long. And if I've been down, the Lord is looking down on me. And he's going to pick me up. He's going to turn me around. And he's going to place my feet on higher ground. I don't know about you, my brother and my sister, but I'm going to stand to my promise that I know that the Lord, he did not bring me this far to leave me now. I thank him. I give him praise because he didn't have to do it. But just because he did, I'm going to say, Lord, thank you. Lord, if you have never done anything else, thank you. Because you have been so good. You have been so good. You have been so good. What more can I ask for when I can go like this? I can't ask for nothing more.
That's right.
I can't ask for nothing more.
That's right.
That's life. Come on, what can I ask for? I can inhale and I can exhale.
Yes.
That's God.
Yes.
So my brother and my sister, don't let no one tell you that the promise is not for you.
Hallelujah.
But the only way you can receive that promise,
first,
you must acknowledge that he is the savior of this world we are living in.
Yes.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
You got to first accept him as your Lord and Savior.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Just before I open the door, let me say this to all my critics, to everyone that's watching. The one them who's saying good and the one them who's saying bad. I love you anyway.
Love you.
Cause that's what life is. I can't speak against you and pray to God. Because God will not answer my prayer.
Yes.
If I can't stand Jimmy, I got to tell Jimmy. I can't tell somebody else.
All right.
So when I get my conscience clear, that means I am pure.
Yes.
That means I can come to him.
Yes, Lord.
Then I can get whatever my promise is from him. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
In my closing, let me say this. Many of us is going through sickness. God, the word teaches us that many are weak and sickly amongst us. That means do not exclude yourself, include yourself. Because it's not me saying this. This is what the word teaching us. Many of us is going through sickness. But sickness did not overtake you. Come on, somebody. You are here to give your testimony. What the Lord has brought you through. Only you and God knows. Let me say this. A few weeks ago, my wife, brother, I was in Rochester with him. And I said to him, we was in the house and I was cooking. And I said to him, let us have a little walk.
Yes.
While we was walking, he walked from right here. Before we could reach that rope there, he could not breathe. He said, we got to turn back. I said, okay, my brother, I understand. Did not know while he was going through all these symptoms, he was about to lose his heart.
Yes.
Come on, my brother and my sister.
Yes.
We don't know what's going to happen to us in life. We was there celebrating. We was there having a good time. Me and him was driving around. And all of a sudden, he ended up in the hospital. Waiting for a heart transplant.
Yes, Lord.
But do you know that the God that you serve? Come on, somebody. I'm keeping it real with you. This is not about no bragging. This is not about no boasting. When you serve God,
yes,
God will take you from a transplant and put a heart into you to raise your hands again and give him praise. Come on, somebody. My brother and my sister, listen to this. It seems impossible. It seems impossible. This is our testimony. It seems impossible. He did not have a heart transplant waiting for him. He was on a, tell somebody, waiting list. He was on a waiting list. But the God that we serve,
The Bible said you got to call upon the prayer warriors them. Because a fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. We are not righteous, but you are people who have sincere heart. I start call upon people who can break through a prayer. And to so help me God, only God's, the glory of God can shine down, only Him. This morning, her brother can call and give her instruction. That means he get, they open his heart, they bust his chest plate, and God give them the heart of love. Yes. Amen, somebody. Amen. That means he have another chance to life. Yes. Don't take life as joke. Don't take it for granted. Because we don't know. Yes. And I look at her, my wife, and I say, you know what? Only God. Because many people who is on a waiting list,
yes, Lord.
They died.
Yes.
Them did not make it.
Yes, Lord.
But is a reason why God give him a heart.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. So that alone made me want to praise him more. Because I see his work. I don't need nobody to tell me nothing again. Because he keep doing it over and over and over and over and over again. Come on, somebody. Only God. Only God. In my prayer, I say, God, the MRI can't see it. The CAT can't see it.
Yes.
The X-ray can't see it.
Yes.
But you see all things.
Yes.
Demonstrate your power.
Yes, Lord.
Come on, somebody.
Yes, Lord.
And to God be the glory.
Yes.
That young man, he will be in Macedonia one day again. Because God give him another chance.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes,
he was waiting for a heart transplant for less than a month.
Yes.
You don't tell me that God is not real. He once was dead. But now he's alive. Come on, somebody. He's alive.
Yes.
Only by God's grace and mercy.
Yes.
So what can you tell me? That the promise don't belong to me? Death can't hold me down.
Mm-hmm.
He's a risen king.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. So I already overcome death. Come on, somebody.
Yes, Lord.
Don't worry about it. Just turn it over to Jesus. And Jesus will fix it for you. Jesus will fix it for you. Even when I see his condition, it bleak. He got tube all over him. He got to leave his comfort zone, leave his home, lay up in a hospital with tubes.
Mm-hmm.
But God show us,
yes,
that he will put things in you,
yes,
what he can take off you.
Right.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
When you just believe.
Yes.
All you got to do is believe.
Yes.
And how do I believe? By his faith. You got to believe in faith,
yes, Lord,
that there is no secret that God can do. If God said to that man, Abraham, he distinctly tell Abraham, your seed shall be blessed.
Yes.
I come from that generation. You come from that generation. So come on. So what is holding you back from give God praise? Even when the pain is rocking your body,
yes.
Even when the sickness is overpowering you,
yes.
Still lift your hands up.
Amen.
Come on, still lift your hands up.
Yes, Lord.
Lift your hands up. I said, Lord, I thank you.
I thank you.
Come on, thank him.
Thank
come
you.
On, stand on your feet. Come on, I finish. Come on, stand on your feet. Come on, stand on your feet. I don't know where you're going through. But just stand on your feet. You might not be her brother, but you know somebody. Come on, somebody. Just give him praise. Just give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Look what he has done. Only God. Only God. Nobody. But Jehovah Jireh. Our provider.
Yes,
nobody.
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 Yes.
Nobody.
Yes,
nobody.
Yes,
nobody.
Hallelujah.
Nobody.
Hallelujah.
Like Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Nobody.
Yes, Lord.
Nobody.
Hallelujah.
So I come to tell you, my brother and my sister, don't let problems get you down.
Amen,
amen somebody.
Amen.
God, that's what problem does. Problem destroy you.
Yes.
You know what problem do? Problem clog your cartridge.
Yes.
Because problem brings stress.
Yes.
And when your cartridge get clogged, that simply means the blood can't flow.
Yes.
And I know Jesus Christ said there is a fountain.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
That means he wants his blood to flow to us. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
You got to know that when you lift your hands up,
yes,
and say, I done all that I can,
yes,
and I'm going to stand.
Yes.
And I'm going to stand.
Yes,
because I'm trusting in your promise.
Yes.
I'm trusting in your promise.
Yes,
not my promise.
Yes.
His promise.
Yes,
God. Yahweh. El Shaddai, Jehovah Tiskobish, he got many names, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nisi, whatever name you want to call him, I call him my healer. Come on somebody, I call him my provider, I call him my sustainer, I call him my keeper, because that's what he is when you believe. His promise. So if God can do it for him, Sister Black, God gonna do it for your mother. You gotta believe that when you're walking, leave Macedonia. You know, say, Mama gonna give you a phone call and say, baby, you don't have to come now. I'm feeling a little better. I believe in the power of prayer. I, Errol Hylton, I don't talk about Reverend because of office, but I love my office. But I believe, God, that's my name.
Yeah.
I believe in the power of prayer.
Yeah.
I believe in the power of prayer. I don't come to church to joyride. I come to church to believe.
Yeah.
I believe in the power of prayer.
I believe.
Yes, Lord. And when you and I believe, the word says we are two and three are what?
Yes.
Touching and agree. Gather in my name. See it here? This is it. I will be, I'm already in the midst. He's in the midst. I'm in the midst.
Yes,
that means whatever you ask for now, I'm honoring you. And I'm blessing you. Because that's the God we... Come on, give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. You do have the church is open. You might don't know Jesus Christ. You might never have that relationship with this person. And you might say to yourself, I'm coming to church and I'm seeing everybody get excited. I don't know if it's excitement or if it's emotion. But I want to know him. I want to know him. I want to get a feel of the excitement. I want to get a feel of the emotion. I want to know him. You can't want something from somebody who you don't willing to engage in a relationship with. Come on, somebody. You got to accept him. And don't worry about it. Some people say, but I can't accept Jesus. I was in the party last night. Listen, we all used to in the party. Some of us even party yesterday. You can still in your house and have your own party. Come on, somebody. But my God is able and my God is just to forgive us. All you got to do is just come. Don't worry about it. Come. You can come as a candidate for baptism. You can even come by letter. Or you come by reinstatement. Just say, I just want to join this church because I love the vibes. Come on. But whichever way you come, just come to Jesus. Don't come to Pastor Gray. Come to Jesus. Jesus is the answer. Do you know him? If you know him, you can be seated. If you know him, because he's in church. If you know him, you can be seated. But if you want a relationship with him, come. If you really want a relationship with him, come. No care who you are, come. 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 Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come. 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 Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Weary, come to Jesus. Wounded, come to Jesus. Sad, come to Jesus. 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 Come to him. Jesus will fix it. Jesus will fix it. He will fix it. He will fix it. He will make the impossible become possible. He will open doors that you could never open. He will allow your feet to walk and tread your feet on the earth that you will never tread before. He will take you to places that you have never been before. Come to Jesus. I feel something pulling me. There is somebody else in this place need to come to him. I feel something pulling me. This is your last chance. Come. Don't make this day pass. Come. Give God your heart. Give the preacher your hands. Come to him. Come to Jesus Christ. To him do I surrender. To him do I freely give? Come to him. Come to him. Jesus. Come to him. God is able. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. We thank you. Come to him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Yes, God. Come to him. Come to him. Come to him. Come to him. It's not too late. It's not too late. Come on. Come on. Don't make nothing pull you back. The next second leaving this place is not promised. Come to him. 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 Come on, church. I need you to stand one more time. Let me have a little bit of silence. Somebody in this sanctuary need to come to him. Yes. And I need you to pray, saying, close your eye and pray with me. Yes, come on. Come on. That person need to come to him. Stop, come. Resist. Come. Come on. Come forth. Come on. Come. Come on. Come on. Come. Come. Come to him. Come to him. He will fix it, my brother. He will fix it, my sister. Come to him. Come to him. Come to him. The Lord is able. He bring you from a mighty long way. When it seems dark and gloomy, he show you light. Come to him. 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 It's not promised. Come to him. Come to him. Come to him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Come to him. Come to him. Come to him. Come to him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Let us hear from our sister Sanderson as she read the report. Blessings. 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 Blessings.
We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank those who are in sanctuary with us this morning. We thank you to be here in the midst of worship this morning. We thank those who are watching us virtually. We thank you for your faithful contribution that you have continually to do to allow this ministry to go forth, that we can spread the gospel over broad. Amen, somebody, both local and internationally. We thank you so much, because it's your faithful donation allow us to do what we are doing. Amen. And we thank you. We thank you. These are the way that you can give. You can give by Zelle. You can give by Cash App. You can give by Giveify. Or you can give by the United States Postal Service. But whichever way you give, the Lord said, He bless a cheerful giver. Amen. And you, my brother and sister, who are in the sanctuary, all you got to do is just, you can't be God-given, no matter how much you try. Don't worry about what they are doing. Worry about what you are doing to make this go forth. Amen? Because we must have to do the will of God. If you don't give, God's church will never close. Amen, somebody. God said, I will supply all your needs. Amen, somebody. So my brother and my sister, let us continually to be a blessing. Amen. You have to pay your tithes and you have to pay your offering. That's all God requires. Amen. And if you do it for God, whether if you do it or not, God is going to do it for you. Because that's what he died for, to save you and I. We thank Tanya, Sister Federado. Do you have anything to say, sister? And listen, one more thing I'm going to say. I'm going to say it early. And believe me, Sister Tanya, she's going to have some advance. Nobody's going to be the cook. This team is going to be taste and see. Taste and see. That's all it is. Taste and see. We're going to have curry. We're going to have oxtail. We're going to have barbecue chicken. We're going to have jerk chicken. We're going to have rice and peas. We're going to have steamed veg. Just come and check out this young man and tell me about if it really tastes good. It named Taste and See. It's going to be in September, but I'm throwing it out there early. Amen, somebody. I want you to put it on your calendar, because it's a Saturday, Sister Tanya. And on Saturdays, you know, we don't like to cook. So you can come and put in your order and get some good food for your family. Taste and see. Amen. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Sister Black, we're praying for you and Mama and those who we, my sister, your husband, we're praying for him and he's going to be all right. All right? We thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Amen? It's in the hands of our finance.